I'm often asked to review an executive's performance, and this is almost always sparked by one of two different situations. Either there's a concern about the executive on the part of the owner or board, or the executive has asked for an increase in compensation and the owner or board feels like a performance assessment should be conducted first. Now, I almost always discover that the owner or board aren't really sure what their performance expectations are for the CEO, which makes them hard to measure, and this creates a problem. The owner or board isn't sure how to resolve their concerns or how to respond to the CEO's requests or to the issues that exist. And so often things are left hanging, and now the relationship feels weird. Wouldn't you like to avoid weird relationships? I'm Christian Montine. I'm an executive coach, I'm a consultant, and I'm the author of The Successful New CEO. Over the years, I've worked with many CEO successions, many boards, many new CEO transitions, and I've had the opportunity to watch what works and what doesn't. I've developed the 12 questions that you must ask if you are considering or have already accepted a new CEO role. As a CEO, you will be assessed whether or not there's a formal review process. Most organizations say that they will do this, but almost none actually do it in practice. And as a result, the most likely scenario is that you'll somehow be informally assessed, perhaps on entirely subjective criteria. It's not best practice, but it is how things usually work. However, you can shape this scenario. So ask them. Make sure that their answers to you are specific, that they're measurable, that they make sense to you and are achievable. Now, if this is already formalized for you, then that's great. But if not, ask them to write their expectations down. If they don't or won't, send them an email or a letter, keep a copy, saying something to the effect of, "I understand that you want me to accomplish A, B, and C within X time frame, measured by Y and Z." This creates a written record of their expectations. It gives you something to aim for in terms of leadership, and it's a starting point for clarification if expectations start to shift, which they often do. So again, ask. The onus is on you to make sure that you know how your performance will be evaluated by others. If you'd like to learn about all 12 questions that you must ask, please click on the link below. Now, if you're stepping into a CEO role for the first time or for the first time in this organization, you can pick up a free copy of my book, The Successful New CEO, by following the links below. I'd love to hear from you, so leave comments or questions down below.